It is time that we decrease this policing system and we invest it into other communities, especially the Black Indigenous communities that have been the primary targets for these police systems.
Protesters in Montreal Saturday say it's time to defund the police, calling for a 50% budget cut of the Montreal police, as well as provincial and federal forces. They say they want to see the resulting money be reinvested into the Black and Indigenous communities.
No peace! No peace!
There's so much intergenerational trauma, but there's not enough generational wealth. There's so much pain and suffering that has been dealt to.
The protest joins in with others across Canada and the U.S. days after Wisconsin man Jacob Blake was seen on video being shot in the back 7 times by a police officer, sparking outrage across North America. Those at the Montreal protest say the police system needs reform.
This is not just an SPVM problem, although here today that's what we're focusing on. This is a police problem. The way the policing is done in general has to be changed.
Some say that starts with reallocating half of the budget to professionals who can respond to nonviolent calls.
If we think about Pierre Coriolan, Nicholas Gibbs, Alain Magloire, those are just few examples of people who actually needed health care, mental health care, but got police officers instead and died.
When we say Black Lives Matter, that's what we mean. You know, these lives are precious to us, and so we need other ways to preserve those lives, because what we've been doing so far has not been working.
Quebec issued new guidelines for all police forces last week for street checks. Montreal police released their new policy in early July to be implemented this fall, saying checks can only happen when based on observable facts and not discriminatory bias. This after a report found Indigenous and Black people were 4 to 5 times more likely to be stopped than white people, which is why some say they distrust police.
Like, Indigenous people see the police more as a threat than as help. And like, a lot of interventions between Indigenous people and police don't go well.
It's hard to believe that police officers who represent the law, who represent justice, could do stuff like that. Until it happened to me. I was 17 years old and I was just sitting in the metro station, and they arrested me for that. They used violence, they put handcuffs on me for no reason.
It's hard to have a good relationship with the police, because you wonder, because every single time you see George Floyd, every time you see Breonna Taylor, especially for Black women, you think of, this could have been me.
The police.
In Montreal, Alicia Rubertucci, City News.